And at another level, they say affected communities as an aggregate, there are certain things they need to do to build their resilience. And the geographical location of this was the eastern region of Uganda, where they have those perennial floods, and then the southwestern and Rwenzori, which are mountainous areas, and they keep getting these landslides. And then, still under environmental variability, there was the issue of rapid environmental degradation. And the focus here is the household, because group members think it is the household that is mostly not adjusting and is breaking down the environment. And the key area where the geographical location was the dry corridor that runs through the center of Uganda, and then it goes to northeastern Uganda, and then the Lake Victoria. They say there's a lot of degradation around Lake Victoria. And then this goes also with pollution, still Lake Victoria highlighted, but here with the environmental pollution, the unit that they think is of focus should be the community, the communities around the lake and the communities in the mining areas. The next main issue in Uganda was epidemics. Members highlighted epidemics are a perennial problem in Uganda. They are and they keep hitting the same spots every year and for factors that are known. So they identified it as an issue. Then who? Members think it is the household that is to focus on to build resilience measures and the district, the institution, the way it drives the agenda of epidemic prevention, because they noted these epidemics keep occurring in the same places every year, sometimes twice a year. In the main areas of focus is the Lake Albert region, the escarpments around Lake Albert. They keep getting epidemics every year, same time of the year, following the rains. And then the West Nile region and the Northern Central region. And then drought famine was another issue for Uganda. The household is, and the community are the main unit, and the geographical location is the dry corridor and then Karamoja region. And then for environmental, we go to Rwanda. Rwanda's main issues are environmental variability leading to floods and landslides and degradation, and then chronic poverty manifesting in widespread malnutrition. The key focus, whom to focus on for environmental variability, they are talking of communities, villages, where their definition of a community is villages, that are repeatedly affected by the floods and landslides. They said the country has already done a countrywide mapping of where these communities are. So there's need to straight away focus on those communities. And they localize northern and western regions, specifically Nyabihu, Rubavu, and Musanze districts. Those are the three districts of focus. And for degradation, it's just one district. Then for poverty and malnutrition also, it's one district. And the unit of focus, they say, is the household. They are saying it's an adaptive issue because the rain is there, the soils are good, but just slight variability leads some households to go into acute malnutrition. So they identified it as an adaptive issue which has to be catered for at household level, not at institutional level, not at at higher level. Then we go to another partner, and that is Tanzania. Tanzania's mainly identified drought, food insecurity, and environmental variability leading to floods, taken together. And the unit of focus for Tanzania, they say it is the district. There was some debate on this, whether it's a community or a household level issue, and they said no, that the institutional framework for predicting drought, informing the people, building capacity, relocating people in event of floods has been built, but the problem is that it is not functional. And they say they have significant devolution of powers to districts, and and districts are supposed to put in place a system that absorbs these shocks. So they locked onto the district, but also noted that for some issues, households directly are concerned. And they localized the areas as areas around Arusha, Dar es Salaam, and Dodoma. And then, next is the fourth member of the team is DRC. DRC notes about a number of issues. Conflict as the main. They said conflict mostly manifests in looting of wealth. In the same areas of conflict, they said they have sexual and gender-based violence meted by both men and women. And then they said also the issue of governance is contributing to the conflict problem. And in terms of who, they noted that it is the provinces that are the unit of application of the resilience measures. And the exact places they said are North Kivu, South Kivu, and North Katanga provinces. With environmental variability, they said there's rapid deforestation. And the unit of focus is the province, because they say it's the one which carries the policy and the enforcement. And they said specifically North Kivu, South Kivu, North Katanga, and Manyema. Two of those provinces, they note, are also the conflict areas, so there can be some integration of approaches. And then they talked of epidemics as another one. Epidemics, we all know that DRC has these deadly epidemics, and mostly they zeroed in on Ituri province in the eastern, Ituri district in the eastern province. And they say the unit of application should be the health zones, or the health sub-districts. So in summary, that is what was discussed by Eastern Africa.
Okay, so are there any additions from DRC